much is all of this gonna cost, right? Good question. In this video, I'm going to discuss the total cost equation. So we've made all of these decisions about our location and our facility layout, and we've chosen our process, how we're gonna produce our product. But we also need to know how much this is going to cost us. And now we use the total cost equation to determine how much we need to produce to determine when we're actually profitable, when we're not profitable, or when we actually break even. So in this example, I'm only using the total cost equation. There's something else called cost volume profit analysis that goes into a little bit more detail where you can adjust different aspects from price and things of that nature, or how much you produce, to determine or to make other adjustments related to breaking even and turning a profit for your organization. But in this example, we're only going to focus on the total cost equation and producing more units or less units to meet our targets. So first of all, the total cost equation is variable costs multiplied by the number of units plus your fixed cost. So when it comes to doing this calculation, we're really trying to determine, are we making a profit based on the number of units that we're producing? So with this first example here, I have the material cost and labor cost per unit. I have the fixed cost, the number of units that we're producing, and the selling price per unit. The reason the selling price is important is because we need to know how much money or revenue we would make after actually selling the product. So first example, we have material and labor cost per unit at $200 and $400. So to get our variable cost, we simply add those together to get $600. Now, the number of units we're producing in this case is 50. So we take that $600 and we multiply by 50. And after multiplying by 50, we then add our fixed cost of $120. $1,000. So that 600 times 50 is going to give us $30,000. When we add that $120,000, we get $150,000 as our total cost. That's how much it cost us to produce those 50 units. Now, when we sell those units at $800 each, we make $40,000. So we have a problem. It cost us $150 to make them, but we only make $40,000. That means we are $110,000 in the red, right? We have to fix that problem a number of ways. Remember, I talked about cost volume profit analysis. We're not doing that. We could increase the price, right? We're not increasing the price. We're going to solve this problem by producing more units. So let's say instead of producing 50 units, we're going to produce 400 units. And we're going to look at this from what we call economies of scale and economies of scope. So economies of scale is simply the ability to produce more goods at a lower cost by better utilizing the same fixed cost. So by doing that, we're producing more units. Our fixed cost and labor cost isn't changing, we're just producing more units. But those costs stay the same, so we can produce more units utilizing the same fixed cost, and that benefit to us is going to help us get to that break-even point because our fixed cost is not changing. That's when we're using economies of scale. We can also do this using economies of scope. Now, this is considered economies of scale through what we call product line diversification. This is when we're building different products or a variety of products on the same equipment, again, still covering or utilizing that same fixed cost. So let's look at this from an economies of scale perspective, and we're simply going to produce more units. So in this case, our labor cost, material cost, is still the same. 200 and 400, so that gives us 600, and we multiply by the number of units, which is 400, that gives us $240,000 in labor and material cost. And then when we add that $120,000, we have now $360,000 in total cost. Now, let's sell these units. Let's sell these units for the same amount of money. $800 times 400 gives us $320,000. Close, better, but doesn't quite hit the mark for us. So in this case, we would still be $40,000 in the red. Again, we're not increasing price. The only thing we can do is utilize economies of scale to see if producing more units will get us to that break-even point or the point to where we're making a profit. So instead of producing 400 units, let's try producing 600 units. So we go to 600, our labor cost is still $600, and we multiply 600 by 600. And that gives us $360,000, and we have to add that $120,000. And that gives us $480,000. Now we have 600 units that we're selling for $800, and we multiply 800 by 600. That gives us $480,000. Bam! We finally hit our break-even point. So we now know that based on these parameters, our labor cost, our material cost, with the same fixed cost, we must produce and sell at least 600 units per month in order to break even. Now we know our break-even point. If we sell, or I mean, if we produce and sell 599 units, and just to show you with the math, we don't break even. We miss it by $200, right? But if we sell 601, boom, we make a profit by $200. So this is why the total cost equation is important. It lets you know when you're going to be profitable based on the numbers you produce and when you're gonna not be profitable based on the numbers you produce. And it's determined by this whole finding where that break-even point is. Again, this is not cost volume profit analysis, right? We're only looking at the total cost equation and utilizing economies of scale where we're producing the same product, more of it, utilizing that same fixed cost, or economies of scope, where we could be producing different products, right, through product line diversification, still trying to make sure we cover only the fixed cost associated with producing those products. So, key takeaway. When it comes to the total cost formula, remember, you're taking your variable cost, which is any cost associated with producing that product, times the number of units that you're producing, plus your fixed cost. And that is going to give you your total cost to produce that product. And in doing so, you want to compare that to what revenue you would make from selling that product at a specific price. And then once you determine what that break-even point is, you can then know what you need to produce in order to make a profit.